Senior isolation is an issue that becomes more prevalent as we get older. However, there are ways to combat feelings alone. And here with more is Samantha Lefebvre from Inspired Living.
Hi.
Hi, Samantha, welcome.
Thank you.
I say your name correctly?
You said it perfectly.
Lovely, lovely. It's such a beautiful name. I hate to mispronounce it.
Thank you.
So begin by telling our viewers about Inspired Living.
Well, Inspired Living is a senior living company, and we specialize in independent living, assisted living, and memory care. And I would say the thing that we do best is take care of moms and dads.
Okay. Now, independent living, so you have apartments, condominiums, I mean, how do they differ a little bit?
Apartments, suites, we have a beautiful location in Lakewood Ranch with over 14 acres of land, mm-hmm. A swimming pool, it's like a cruise ship on land.
It is beautiful, mm-hmm. Yes. So people have a lot of flexibility when they move into your facility.
Absolutely.
Okay. So our topic today is senior isolation, and
yes.
What would you like to tell us about that?
Well, did you know that actually 30% of our population here in Sarasota is actually above the age of 65? And within that,
yes.
46% are actually living alone. So those are the folks that probably don't drive any longer. Mm-hmm. Maybe they don't have family that lives in town, mm-hmm. or maybe they don't have any family left at all. And so those are our folks in the community that we worry a little bit about with senior isolation.
Okay, and what exactly is that, and how do you know whether you're experiencing that?
So.
There, or do you know?
You know, if you don't have the means to be able to transport yourself, so maybe you don't have a driver's license any longer.
Uh-huh.
If you find yourself eating alone, it's hard to get to your appointments.
Yeah.
Go to the grocery stores. Things that used to be no trouble at all suddenly become a daunting task.
Yeah, and overwhelming.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the older you get, I mean, I see it in my neighbors. So
yes.
It is a common thing. What can you do to help break up social isolation?
Well, at Inspired Living, what we do is we try and create as many opportunities as we can for people to develop companionship and fellowship. As humans, we weren't programmed, our brains weren't wired to be alone.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it makes it a little bit more troublesome when you are alone. And so we provide transportation. We create moments where we can bring people to the theater, out for dinner, to bring them to their appointments, their grocery store, to go see their friend. We also have a wider range of wonderful activities that come into our properties and our communities as well, that are engaging and uplifting.
Like,
so that's
like
helpful.
What? Like what's
that? So we have live entertainment, live music,
mm-hmm.
We have parties, we have magicians come in, we are really involved in the Sarasota arts community,
okay.
So we have an improv group that comes in and works with our residents, and it's just a lot of fun.
It is, and it's a beautiful, beautiful community.
Thank you.
I was fortunate enough to tour it last week.
Thank you.
Now, for our viewers out there, I'm sure I know several people, I'm sure a lot of our viewers do. How could our viewers help people that they know that may be suffering from senior isolation?
Sure. Well, I think one thing to keep in mind is if you ask your neighbor, how you doing? Is there anything I can get for you? They're gonna say no. Most people will say no.
Exactly.
We're all afraid to ask for help.
Right.
So I would suggest.
Or it's embarrassing.
Yeah.
You know.
It can be, exactly. Especially when you're so prideful and you're used to
mm-hmm.
providing for yourself and doing everything on your
sure.
own. So I would suggest that we all be community minded and strive to be 1% better every day. That's something that I learned at Inspired Living. That's our motto. And we do it every day. And I think if all of us as a whole in the community can do that, that would help a lot. And what that looks like by being 1% better in the community is don't ask, just bring a meal to your neighbor. Invite them over for dinner or to church.
Mm-hmm.
I, for instance, have a neighbor who's 84. She lives down the street. And my favorite thing to do on a Friday after I get out of work is to go down and spend some time with her. And she loves my children, so to bring the children around. And I don't ask her,
yeah.
we just do it. And you can see you can see that it's a positive impact.
It's uplifting for her.
Yes.
Sure. And that's it. It's the simple things that you can do. It doesn't necessarily have to be sending flowers or bringing flowers.
Yeah.
It's just, or even picking up the phone.
Exactly. It's
you
simple.
Know, and seeing how are you doing today.
Absolutely.
So all of these, we should be mindful of this because we are, again, you said, in an aging community.
Yes.
And a lot of younger people, you know, find themselves maybe not engaging as much as they could. So as far as a community as a whole, what can you see our community doing to kind of change this?
Well, I would say it would be nice if we could become a little bit more intergenerational, you know, invite your neighbors to participate in church groups or community groups and involvement that you know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And just, you know, be aware.
Right.
Be on the lookout.
Tell us a little bit about specifically some of the activities that you offer at Inspire Living.
Well, so we have fitness clubs at Inspired Living.
Mm-hmm.
We have, yesterday I witnessed a dancing drumming circle that was really unique and,
wow,
and cool.
That you brought in for the residents to,
yes,
to see.
Yes, yeah.
Okay.
We have painting, we have art projects, pet therapy.
Oh.
Yes, and that's really fun.
And your residents can have their pets, is that correct?
Residents can have their pets.
I love it.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's very important.
Yeah, it is. Yep. I mean, it's, that alone combats senior
yeah.
loneliness.
Yeah. And you have a putting green, I saw.
We have a putting green, which is wonderful.
Pool. So
yeah.
There's a range of things. And I'm sure if one of your residents asked that you could probably accommodate them. If they were musically inclined, you have a piano, I know, at one of them. Right?
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So all of those opportunities are out there. And for more information, where should our viewers go, Samantha?
For more information, you should check out our website,
okay,
inspiredliving.care, and contact the number below.
Okay.
And don't be shy. Reach out to me, anybody, and come on in for lunch. We'd love to be your friend.
Great. Thanks. Mm-hmm. So nice to meet you.
Thanks for having me.
I'll see you next time.
Sounds great.
Thank you for joining us on Aging Gracefully. Find more episodes throughout the season on snntv.com. Join us next time for more tips on living a happy and healthier life.